Critics tonight, the world's largest retailer airing two TV ads today, defending its record as a good employer and corporate citizen.
There is one company that in one day, today, is providing more than 1 million people with the security of health insurance. Through a choice of different plans designed to meet their individual needs, every associate can qualify for health insurance with premiums that cost less than a dollar a day. And it is this one company that has moved more than 150,000 uninsured Americans into a company-sponsored insurance plan. This one company, your neighborhood Walmart.
Will these ads be enough to change people's perception of the company? And does that matter? Laura Rice is partner of Rice and Rice and Bishop Ira Combs, Reverend with the Greater Bible Way Temple. Laura, let me start with you. Will this ad work? I mean, are these sorts of ads with companies touting how great they are ever really effective?
They're not effective because advertising doesn't have the ability to change a mind. Advertising is only good to reinforce something that people already believe. And people, unfortunately, believe that Walmart isn't a great place to work and they don't treat their workers well. So using advertising is not going to be effective. And there's two reasons. One, it lacks credibility and it's a self-serving message. It's what they themselves are saying about themselves. And we know we can't trust that.
Bishop Combs, what do you say about that? I mean, does Walmart get a bad rap here? Do they deserve this kind of grief?
Well, quite to the contrary. The question is Walmart overreaching? And the answer is not so. I think it's in the words of Ralph Waldo Emerson in a lecture back in the 1800s, said, if a man can write a better book, build a better mousetrap, or preach a better sermon than his neighbor, even if he builds his house in the woods, the world will make a beaten path to its doorstep.
Wait, what does that have to do with Walmart?
This is what Walmart has experienced in terms of being a retailer that meets the people's needs, that in fact is a low-cost retailer in terms of selling goods and services to the public that are affordable and cutting the cost of these goods and services. And in fact, their fourth quarter results prove it. They've increased in terms of year over year by 1 to 2% according to their predictions, and people enjoy shopping at Walmart. And this advertisement will just continue to encourage people to see that Walmart is in fact a good retailer and a good corporate citizen.
I have to take issue with that, though, because I'm seeing today, I mean, Goldman Sachs going ahead and downgrading the company. It seems like Walmart has much bigger issues to focus on here rather than just what their image is. I mean, they lost a major member of their management team. They're confusing their core message. Laura, don't they have bigger problems right now than focusing on this?
Well, they have huge problems, one of which is a bad PR and image problem that I think needed to be addressed years, maybe decades ago to start, you know, building a communication with the public, having the CEO be more forthcoming. Unfortunately, Sam Walton isn't around to help many of these image problems. It would have been very helpful to have him say, hey, I'm not going to be a cheapskate. I'm going to be a good leader, and I'm going to lead the way, perhaps even raising the minimum wage, making a new Walmart minimum wage. The other problem at Walmart is they're going in both directions. Walmart has failed in trying to sell upscale products,
right,
in terms of expensive wine, expensive clothes. These things have been terrible. I mean, they advertised in Elle magazine, Vogue magazine, trying to be fashionable. I don't think those ladies on Park Avenue are changing their ways.
Laura,
they're going downscale as well.
I think that they have defined themselves as a low-cost retailer, and this is why, in fact, they are doing good to stick with that niche that they have carved out in the market. And
they aren't sticking with that niche. I think that's the problem right now. And what I wonder is, does it matter if people perceive them to not be a great company? I mean, our viewers here are stockholders, so what we care about is, are they giving a return to their stockholders? What do you think about that, Bishop Combs? I mean, it seems like their message is mixed.
I think that the numbers bear out that people think that Walmart is a good retailer and a good corporate citizen. I think that their track record speaks for itself in terms of it going into low-income areas, urban centers, providing jobs for areas that have been economically depressed. I think that their philanthropic efforts of contributing to the Children's Miracle Network, also the Salvation Army recently during the Christmas season, where they opened their doors to the Salvation Army and allowed them to stand in front of their 3,000 to 5,000 stores and collect contributions.
That's
which
true.
It in fact is said that some close to $30 million plus came in to help the Salvation Army.
Yeah, those are all things that we don't hear a lot about.
Communities. And I think, again, Walmart does have to make sure that it sticks with its core values, its core focus with regard to being a low-cost retailer.
That has to be.
But their track record speaks for itself. The majority of people who are polled by all polls are satisfied shopping at Walmart.
The majority of people have a poor image of what they're doing.
And have a positive image of Walmart, as a matter of fact.
All right, guys, we have to wrap it up. I'm so sorry. That has to be the last word. Thank you so much for joining us.